Now, we're up to the man who says he was almost dropped by his record company after they heard his last album. It was more than 2 years ago that this rocker from Indiana had completed the album called American Fool. And when he turned it over to his record label, PolyGram, he said he thought it was some of the best work that he'd ever done. But he told us the company didn't agree. They said there were no hit songs on the album, and it would absolutely ruin this man's career. The executives even considered dropping this artist from their label. However, PolyGram went ahead and released American Fool, but without any fanfare. And here's what happened. The first single from the album, Hurt So Good, went to number two. The follow-up, Jack and Diane, became a number one smash. And a third single, Hand to Hold On To, reached number 19. So much for an album the experts said didn't have any hits. And an album that also went to number one on the album chart and stayed there for 9 weeks. The album American Fool by John Cougar Mellencamp. John says that today he doesn't hold a grudge against the people who didn't think much of his album. He says, quote, "Some of the people who badmouth the record and are decent individuals have since come forth and said, I didn't think the record had a shot, but I was wrong. I respect people who own up to that. If I'm wrong, I'll admit it." End of quote by John Cougar Mellencamp. Ironically, in the current hit from his album, Uh-Huh, John sings, "I fight authority and authority always wins." But in this case, the case of American Fool, it was John Cougar Mellencamp who came out on top. At number 16 this week on American Top 40, here's the Authority song. John Cougar Mellencamp, born, raised, and now living in the state of Indiana. He's at number 16 again this week, sixth week in the countdown with the Authority song. As the countdown rolls on, Casey's Coast to Coast. We're counting down the top 40 hits of the 1980s so far. I'm Casey Kasem. This next song is the only hit in our special survey that didn't hit number one. In 1982, it hit number two and spent enough weeks on the chart to make it as one of the decade's top songs. But the singer's record company didn't really think much of this song at first, and John Cougar Mellencamp thought that was pretty funny.
When they heard Hurt So Good, it was like, this is horrible. I hate this, you know, we don't like this. I think they thought I was going to evolve into it. I think PolyGram really did not have any idea what I was about, because they really weren't interested. I wasn't selling records. Matter of fact, they considered dropping me off the label at that point.
Well, John Mellencamp had the last laugh. His album, American Fool, hit number one. And that song the record company didn't think much of became the biggest hit of his career. At number 39, here's Hurt So Good. Sometimes love don't feel like it should. Hurt So Good. John Cougar Mellencamp and the 39th biggest hit so far in the 1980s. Kissy's Coast to Coast.